Kirchhoff's voltage law. Today we will discuss about if we are tracing the circuit, we are tracing the circuit in the direction opposite to the our given direction of current, then how this KVL is applied. This process we will discuss here. Let's say we are deciding the path of the current I1, and this is I2. Now we will trace the circuit not in the direction of I1, we will go opposite to the direction of I1 in mesh 1, and in mesh 2 we are also tracing the circuit in direction opposite to that of I2. Let's see how this KVL helps us. And it is independent of the direction of tracing, and how the sign convention changes, how the voltage drop, how the voltage gain changes. Let's see it. In mesh, this is mesh first. We are tracing the circuit in direction opposite to that of current. Current is flowing in this way. We will trace in this way. Here, minus 9. Then, at battery side, there will be the voltage drop. And at 10 ohm resistance, there will be voltage gain. If we are tracing the circuit in direction opposite to that of the given direction of the current. So here there will be current gain plus I1 plus I2. They have additive effect because I1 and I2 are in the same direction. There will be voltage gain, and then 10, then plus 9 I1 is equal to 0. So minus 9 volt plus 10 I1 plus 10 I2 plus 9 I1 is equal to 0. So 10 I1, 9 I1, 19 I1 plus 10 I2 is equal to 9. Now we will go to the in mesh second. In mesh second, the I2 is flowing, and we have given the direction, we have decided the direction in this direction from positive plate to negative plate. As we are already discussed that we are now tracing the mesh, tracing that circuit in the direction opposite to that of I2. So there will be voltage drop at battery side, and there will be the voltage gain, that is positive sign for the resistance. Let's check there. In the direction opposite means I2 is here, we are going here, minus 10, then plus 10 I1 plus I2 plus 11 I2 is equal to 0. 10 I1 plus 10 I2 plus 11 I2 is equal to 10 I1 plus 10 plus 10, 20 plus 1, 21 I2 is equal to 10. This is first equation, this is second equation. By solving equation first and second, we get the values of I1 and I2 by solving equation first and second using calculator. I have already discussed and how to and discussed about how to solve the equation in two variables using calculator. Then we will find by solving equation first and second, we will get the values of I1 is equal to 0.29 ampere and I2 0.33 ampere. If we add this both I1 plus I2, 334 ampere, sorry. If we add I1 plus I2, that is the current flowing through the 10 ohm resistance in the direction, in this direction, the I1 and I2 are flowing in this direction. It will be 0.624 ampere. Thank you.